Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 6.1, Problem 1. This is Section 6.1, Problem Number 1. It says, consider each of the probability distributions listed below, and for each one, determine if it is valid or invalid. So for each one, you have to consider the three rules you have for a probability distribution. First of all, everything in the first column must be a number. Second, everything in the second column must be between 0 and 1. And third, the total of the second column must be a total of 1. So as we look at the first probability distribution, everything in the first column is a number. That's good. Everything in the second column is between 0 and 1. That's good. But the total is a lot more than 1. If you add this up, 0.4 and 0.4 is 0.8. 0.8 and another 0.4, you're up to 1.2, you're already over 1. Then another one is 1.6 and then 2.0, a lot more than 1. So the first one is invalid. And the reason being that the total of that second column is not 1. Now the second probability distribution, everything in the first column is a number. Notice you have a negative here? That's okay, it's a number. You can't have a negative in the second column. The second column, everything is between 0 and 1, that's good. And if you get a total of the second column, the total is 1. 0.2 and 0.2 is 0.4. 0.4 plus another 0.2 is 0.6. Plus another 0.2 is 0.8. And plus the last 0.2 is 1.0. So all three rules are satisfied. So the second probability distribution is valid. Now the third one. One of the items in the first column is not a number. So the first rule is everything in the first column must be a number. The fact that we have red, I don't even have to consider the other rules. Right away, this third probability distribution is invalid. The fourth one, everything in the first column is a number. Everything in the second column is not between 0 and 1. Negative 0.5 is not between 0 and 1. So even if it does add up to 1.0, the fact that one of the values is negative in the second column makes the fourth probability distribution invalid. And finally, the last probability distribution. First rule, everything in the first column is a number. It doesn't start with 1, but that's okay. These are all numbers in the first column. Everything in the second column is between 0 and 1. Now, does the total of the second column add up to 1.0? Well, 0.1 and 0.2 is 0.3. 0.3 plus another 0.3 is 0.6. 0.6 and 0.2 is 0.8. 0.8 plus 0.1 is 0.9. Doesn't quite add up to 1.0. So it's invalid. It has to be 1.0, so it's not quite enough.